Hello, RC fans. Racing 393. A little bit of a chat, really. A quick video. You can see BRCA logo behind me, so it is related to that, and it's not a moan. I just looking on the BRCA website. I was looking for the LMP12 schedule for the national rounds. Thinking to myself, should I do anything? You know what I'm going to do? Because I haven't actually raced a lot at the Wickham RC Club as much as I wanted. I've missed a couple because of work. They had at the time of this recording, they had a club meeting this week on the Tuesday, but I couldn't make it. I was too busy with work and things like that. So I decided, I was just looking on the website, and I thought maybe, what would I do? How would I go about doing all the rounds? Now, you got to remember, people that do this, it's much higher level than what I'm at. So that is a little bit of a worry. I'll be honest, I'm not in a position where I think I'm going to do this. But I thought I'd just run through some geographical costings for you. So it's 9 rounds. Now, I don't know how many of the rounds count, so you wouldn't have to do them all. But I was just costing up, supposing I did. So 9 rounds. The online fee on the BRC, I put it in my basket to see how much it was, £275 race fees. So on that basis, that looks, sounds expensive, but when you compare that cost to race fees on a big circuit, like real life racing, that's pretty much what you'd pay anyway for one event. But that's 9 rounds. Now, I'm based in Hampshire. My nearest national round venue is Eastbourne. All the rest are quite a way away. So, I've quickly totted up times and mileage. So, we start off in October, end of October, West Bridford. Sorry, I can't see it because of my eyes and the light. So, to me, that's a one-day event, 147 miles away, and that's going to take me, as the crow flies, 2¾ hours. One day. In my opinion, if I did that, I'd have to stay over perhaps the night before or even after the race. I personally would find that quite difficult to travel on my own up there, race and home. Bear in mind, it finishes at roughly, what does it finish at, 6 o'clock? I'm just guessing. We just use it as a round number. You're not going to get home until 9. It doesn't sound a huge amount, but you're going to leave at like 4 in the morning. It's a long day. 4 in the morning to 9 at night. And it's only me driving. Difficult. Doable, but difficult. And then on the 6th of the 11th, Stafford. Similar sort of distances. 138 miles from me, 2½ hours. Probably, I don't know, it's only 15 minutes in it, but it's a long way to go on your, driving all the way up there, racing for the day, which in itself, I wouldn't say it's tiring, but it's a long day, isn't it? And then driving home again. You could argue, yeah, you should be able to do that on your own. You should be able to. I'm not sure if I could. Maybe back in the day, you know, when I was racing Superstocks, the furthest I went is like Ipswich. But I have done like Birmingham Wheels when it was there. So Ipswich is like 2½ hours. And there was the time when I was towing up there, racing and towing home. Leaving at like 1 o'clock in the afternoon, not getting home to like 12, 1 o'clock in the morning. It's a good 12-hour day. Probably harder racing in a real car, in a stock car on an oval, than a rally control car, as in physically harder, more physical on yourself rather than mentally. But don't know. You can argue, maybe. Could I do it in a day? Could I not? Should I? Shouldn't I? Anyway, 7th for the 12th and the 8th for the 12th, the first 2 days, so definitely an overnighter. Crew. Even further, 178 miles from me. 3 hours, just over 3 hours, 3 hours, 8 minutes, with an overnight stay. So, in my eyes, doable. Finishing at 6, you're going to get home late. It's going to affect the next day with what I do. So, I'm a driving instructor, so I wouldn't be able to go after that long weekend, get home at like 9 or 10, whatever time I got home, go straight to bed and get up and start and doing driving lessons the next day without having a bit of a break. So, you're going to lose. I'd have to block my diary out so I didn't book lessons and start late or even have the Monday off. I don't know, but either way, you're like losing a bit of money there. I can't just get up next day all tired and expect to go and deliver a driving lesson. So there's things I have to consider if I did this. Anyway, 2 day a crew, and then we got Chesterfield. I can't read my own writing. Another 2 day, that's in next year, January. 2 days, again, 3 hours away from me, 161 miles, overnight stay, similar process about work the next day. Probably, you know, doable, not the end of the world, but, you know, it doesn't just include the Friday, the Saturday and the Sunday. Now, you've got to leave early, so it makes that day very long, where the Sunday's a bit more manageable because you're going to stay overnight, blah, blah, blah. 15th for the 2nd, Tamworth. Not too bad. This one would be probably, it's just outside of Birmingham for me, so 125 miles, just over 2 hours. That wouldn't require an overnight stay, so I'd better do that in 1 day, not too bad. And then Eastbourne, local to me as ish, so 90 miles, give or take. Because of the type of road, it's not an M road, it goes on to an A road, so 2 hours. But 2 days overnight stay. So you look at all these. So you've got like, now I've sort of priced it up a little bit. So the long distance ones, I did price in there that I might have to stay overnight of the night before, which would probably make sense rather than the night afterwards. Depends on the cost. Now I don't know the costs of the B&Bs or what you choose, but averaging it out just to make the sums easy, it could be more, could be less. Round one, that's going to use, because you've got to go there and back, and I've priced it up on, like, I've really priced it up, but a good 3/4 of a tank on my car, 294 miles. That would be West Bridford and back. Is that right? Bridford? How do you say it? Don't know. So that's going to cost at least 50 quid's worth of fuel. And maybe an overnight stay. Maybe. The next one, there and back, 3/4 of a tank. Yet again, Stafford, quite far. A good, you know, 2.5 hours there and back. 200 odd miles. Another 3/4 of a tank. A good... No, I don't know. I've used this maybe 45 quid, 40 quid maybe on my car. 50 quid, I've put it, sort of rounded up a little bit. Another 50 quid. This one here, one tank of fuel, definitely just over. So that's round, I'm looking at my notes here, not the camera, fourth. Round three, oh, it's two days. Actually, is it 2 days? Yeah, 2 days. Further away, nearly 178 miles there and back. That's 356 miles. That's a good tank of fuel. That's probably getting on for plus 50 quid of fuel. So you can, going down here anyway, you're looking at pretty similar stats here with the fuel. I've totaled it up to around about £300. Have I got £300? Yeah. Fuel, 300 quid. So there's 575 with entry fee and fuel. I've sort of priced this up 6 B&Bs overnight. You might better cut this down. It's not going to make a massive difference for me, because I'm that far away. It's a good, based on the B&B, £300 in B&B. So it's just overnight, or yeah, overnight. What's that, 50 quid? Again, you might be able to reduce that a little bit. But another 300 pounds. So 6 £875, fuel, entry fee, and overnight. Now, a lot of people might better stay with other people. I don't know anybody up that way, so I've got to assume that if I did do it, this is all hypothetical, so I doubt I will. It's just a conversation I'm having with you. There's, like I say, £875. So if you round that up, because you can go to and from the B&B, maybe I got my figures wrong, maybe the price of fuel will go up after October, you know, blah, 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 blah. So we're looking at entry, fuel and B&B, about £900. In racing terms, and going racing, because it is classed as racing, that's not that expensive. You know, you can go to a race meeting, and you've got the kit, and you go to a race meeting, and you stay overnight, and you've got the entry fee, and the fuel, if you're travelling, it's going to probably cost you more than that, isn't it? Even I know for a fact that when I raced Superstock, when I raced up in Ipswich and things like that, when you consider the race weekend, it's going to probably cost you probably about that. So I've also got here, I've sort of rounded it up, the running costs of an RC car at that level. So you're going to break stuff. So how do you sort of work that out? You know, you might damage your battery. You're going to have got to buy tyres. Other damage. Most of that stuff I've got, but I haven't got spare batteries. So I don't know. This is the bit I'm guessing at. How, you know, the top guys, I can't compare near them. They're running tyres at every other race, aren't they? Or every race. I probably wouldn't do that. But anyway, they're not that expensive, the tyres. But I've summarised the running cost. It might be more than this, thinking about it, for the all those rounds. It's got to cost more than this, has it not? I don't know. £200? Is that complete out of sync? If you know, let me know. How much does it cost to run your car for that? As in spares, damage that you might get, motors that might come out, do you buy another motor? Do you need new batteries? Do your batteries last? Now, I'm just using the basis I've got everything, but if I had to buy stuff, would £200 be, is that ridiculously high or is it miles too low? So I'll put £200. We'll see how we get on from there. And then we've got like food. You know, if you're staying overnight, if you're going to get something locally from a shop, or do you sit in a local restaurant, or do you get stuff from the venue? I mean, like a there and back, you're going to probably take sandwiches with you, maybe. So you perhaps wouldn't necessarily cost you a lot because you'd already have it. I'm not going to cost what you'd buy at home, you know. But if you're staying overnight, or maybe you'll get a McDonald's or something, and I don't know, and it's just over the whole nine rounds. So I put like £100 of fuel, £100 of food. Again, that'll fluctuate a little bit. I'm just trying to keep the figures easy to work out. And then you've got like, well, if I did LMP12, I've got an Eclipse 4. Eclipse 5 is out. I haven't got that. And will Schumacher bring out an Eclipse 6? Now, I don't have to buy a car, but if you did, they've got a new one out. They're about £300 just over, aren't they? So I want to keep the numbers, like I've said, neutral. So without buying a car, because I don't need to, nine rounds, fuel, overnight stays, £1,200. Now, for racing for a series, £1,200, and that could go up or down, couldn't it? You might think, that's not bad. But it's not just down the road. It's a good full day. And for me, it's probably going to affect work day as well. You know, I can't just book a holiday and get paid. I'm self-employed, so if I'm not working, I don't earn. Probably a lot of people like that. It's nothing new. But I think you've got to take that out of the equation, because regardless of what I would do, if I was racing in, you know, real life, or as in the full-size car, or RC racing, there's going to be costs involved with not working. Now, most people would have holidays, so you'd still get paid. So that'd be quite lucky. I've been there, done that. So we're looking at about £1,200 to do all those rounds, considering I'm going to be in the bottom rank, being lapped, not doing particularly well, as opposed to the national drivers that are good, or at least middle of the road good. But would I get better? Would I improve? Definitely. Even though I haven't raced at my local Wickham club, that's my fault. So £1,200, this, that, just say for argument's sake, you have to buy a new car. And I'll go with Schumacher, because I doubt I'll go anywhere else, only because I've got Schumacher. So an Eclipse 5, £300. Some of the stuff's interchangeable, isn't it, for the two fours and a five. If I brought a six out, how different is that going to be to the four? You know, would you need to buy a load more spares? Would it be more expensive? Would that £300 become £500? Because you'd have to go kit it up. Not at every race, clearly, because it's spread out over that, you know, you wouldn't have to bang it all in at the beginning. But, you know, I'm looking at that whole program. So, if you've, there's people out there that have done it. I don't know whether they watch this channel or not. I don't know. But is that realistic? Am I completely way off of the costings? I think the fuel's pretty accurate. The race fees, well, they're sort of fixed. That's just what it is. When you don't get a discount for doing all nine rounds. Do you have to do all nine rounds? So some of those you could drop, couldn't you? So the cost will come down. But even if you're sort of looking somewhere between £1,000 and £1,500 to do that rounds, what do you reckon? I've looked at my diary, actually, to see whether or not I can fit them in. I mean, October's pretty close. I'll have to get my skates on if I was going to do that. And that's a long way off. West Bridford. How do you pronounce that? Why can't I say it? Bridford? Brightford? Why don't I know? But if I didn't do that, you know, it's not going to make a big difference to the outcome of my racing at this level. It'd be the same. But I'm just thinking, we're all getting older. Would I be doing this, you know, in 10 years? Maybe not. Might not be able to. So should I do it now and look back and think, oh, should I have done that? Give it a go. It's a big commitment. But anyway, it's not really about shall I, shan't I, will I, won't I. It was more a case of how much would it cost me? And is it worth me doing it? I'd probably quite enjoy it. But it's quite a time, because for me, I'm way down south and these are all up north. Well, Midlands. I call it north because it's past the Watford Gap. Unless I get sponsors. That ain't going to happen. Maybe I'll go GoFundMe or something. If they paid half, I can pay the other half. I don't know. If you can't afford to race, you shouldn't do it. That's my motto. Shouldn't rely on people. Although racing is about sponsors, isn't it? What do you think? Anyway, it's a quick video. It's not a rant. It's not a moan. It's just a sort of a, what would you do? Do you do it? Have you done it? Are you doing it? I'd like to hear from people that have and that are doing it. Any feedback? Hope you enjoy the video. And I'll see you soon, whatever way I do this. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.